In my last video, I talked about what autumn is and what it's known for, but I never talked about what causes it, and all of the other seasons, for that matter. The reason behind it is actually pretty interesting, and while the explanation itself is pretty simple, there are a lot of interesting quirks that help to spice things up a bit too. Now, before we get into what the explanation is, I would appreciate if you liked the video, subscribe to your channel, and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for future content. Now, the reasoning is pretty simple. It all has to do with the Earth's axis, aka the thing that Earth rotates around. The axis is tilted 23.5 degrees, and while that might not sound significant, that tilt pretty much causes our season. Now, the axis doesn't actually move. The season happens when the Earth moves in its orbit, changing the way each hemisphere is oriented toward the sun. For example, when the Earth is at a point in its orbit where the northern hemisphere is tilted toward the sun, they get longer days, which in turn leads to more solar radiation, which heats the surface up. In other words, summer. Likewise, when the northern hemisphere is tilted away from the sun 6 months later, the days get shorter, which leads to less solar radiation reaching the ground, aka winter. Twice a year, the Earth is at a point in its orbit where the axis isn't oriented toward the sun in either hemisphere, which causes solar radiation to hit in equal amounts everywhere, aka the equinoxes. When they say that there is an exact time that the season starts, that time is either when maximum orientation toward or away from the sun occurs, or when there is zero orientation either way. Now, what are some of the interesting aspects of this explanation? For one, the Earth's orbit is elliptical, meaning that in times the Earth is closer to the sun than others. So, interestingly, perihelion, or the closest point to the sun, happens in early January, while aphelion, or the furthest point from the sun, happens in early July. As a result, the seasons are less extreme in the northern hemisphere because they get less solar radiation during the summer and more during the winter. On the other hand, the southern hemisphere seasons are more extreme as they coincide with the highest and lowest amounts of solar radiation received in Earth's orbit. Another interesting thing is that since the Earth is tilted by 23.5 degrees, there is an area above 66.5 degrees from the equator where it is possible to go several months without sunlight during the winter and several months with sunlight during the summer. However, these areas are among the coldest places on the planet even during summer because the solar radiation they do get is very indirect, so the surface isn't heated as efficiently. Finally, there is a situation on some exoplanets where seasons don't matter at all. How? Well, these planets are tidally locked to their star, meaning one side of the planet always faces it. So, as a result, that side of the planet is in perpetual daylight, heating the surface to extreme levels, while the other side is always dark, so it is very cold. As a result, some of these planets could have a small zone where day and night meet, where conditions are favorable for life development. And with that concludes this video about seasons and what causes them. If you want to know more about possible life on planets outside of our solar system, as well as exoplanets in general, let me know in the comments. As always, I'd appreciate if you liked the video, subscribe to your channel, and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for future content. Thanks, and have a great day.